Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. I hope you all are doing absolutely fine. My name is Prince and you are watching the Tech Stream. And today I am going to review a very popular custom ROM which goes by the name of Havok OS, and we'll see what this ROM brings on the table for you and why it is considered one of the best ROMs in the market. So without wasting any more time, let's get started. So this video is going to be a little bit longer than usual, and we'll be going through every feature that this ROM provides, so let's actually begin. Havok OS is one of the most popular AOSP based ROMs, and it is very close to Pixel-like experience. It is full feature packed and it comes with a plethora of customization options. Now I'm running Havok OS on my OnePlus 5 device. I'm using the version 2.9, which is the Pi based version. I'm using version 2.9 and not version 3 because OnePlus 5 is my daily driver phone and I use it every day. Version 3 of this ROM, which is Android Q based, is also available, but it is in beta stages, so I'm not using it on my OnePlus 5 as of now, but I'm soon going to try the Havok OS version 3, which is Android Q based. Also, if you want to know how to install this custom ROM on your device, so drop a comment and I'll make another video about that. Now Havok OS comes with a very few preloaded apps, and by flashing the ROM you have to select your own Google Apps package, and on my device I have flashed Google Apps Nano package, which is a very light and minimal version of the bare minimum Google Apps which are required to run your device. So that means my phone doesn't have extra Google Apps which I don't use, like the Google Photos app or Google Play Music app, and this leads to extra free space in my system memory, which is a good point. Havok OS also has OnePlus Gallery and camera absolutely working, so that's a plus for this ROM, and this is one of the reasons why I'm not using the version 3 of Havok OS, because in version 3 of Havok OS you can't use OnePlus camera and gallery, but Google Cam is working. Now let me take you to the customization section and all the customization that are provided in this ROM. So just go to your phone settings and there you can see Havok setting option, rec some Havok. Now when we go inside Havok settings, you can see there is a plethora of customization options, and we'll go through each one by one. So the first option is status bar. In status bar gestures, you have features like double tap status bar to sleep, brightness control by swiping on the status bar, you have quick pull down, and then you have smart pull down, and then we have the clock and date customization options. And if you go into it, you can see there's a lot of options to customize the date and time of your phone. So in clock and date settings, you can change the clock style, the AM/PM style, you can change the seconds, you can change the font size and also the font style. So there's a lots and lots of options for you to customize your clock and date. Now if we come back, then we have the battery size. I'm using the Android Q battery size, but we also have many other battery styles like portrait, circle, circle, dotted. Below that we have the battery percentage and battery bar options. Now battery bar is one of my favorite customization options. As you can see, I have a battery bar on the top of my status bar, so you can change all those settings for the battery bar here, like the location should be above the start status bar or above the nav bar or below nav bar. Then you have the style like center, mirror or regular or reverse. You can also change the thickness and color of this battery bar. Now in network option, we have network traffic, that where we want to show the network traffic indicator, and then we have the custom carrier label, and here you can change your custom carrier label and you can change its location, whether to show it on the lock screen or status bar or both. As you can see, I have set the label to never settle and location to lock screen. So on the top left corner of my lock screen it says never settle. I can also change its label size, its font and color. Now coming back to status bar settings, we have logo options. We can have a custom logo. As you can see on the top right corner in my status bar, I have a yin yang logo, and here are a lot of logo styles you can choose from, like emoji or cannabis, sitar, fire, flags. There's a lots and lots of options. You can also change its position and its color also. Now if we come back, then we have the status bar icons, and here we can toggle the visibility of icons in the status bar. Then we have the notification count, battery Bluetooth status, 4G icon and the 4G icon and data disabled icon. And then we have the breathing notification options for SMS, missed calls and voicemail. Now if we come back to the Havok settings, next option is quick settings. Here you can customize the layout of your quick settings, that how many rows you want in portrait and landscape mode, how many columns you want in portrait and landscape mode, and you can see for portrait I've set it up to 7 columns and 3 rows. Then we have how many quick setting tiles you want in the quick bar. So as you can see, I've set 8 there. Then you have other options for showing the brightness slider. Brightness slider should be shown on the bottom of quick settings, auto brightness icon, auto brightness on right, and brightness control buttons. Below that we can change if you want the quick setting tile title or not, and below that we have footer options like VPN warning settings icon and running services icon, so you can change all that from here. And now the third option is interface settings, and this is one of my favorite settings. From interface settings you can change the UI style, which is either Pixel or AOSP, and then you have the background color. So you can change the background color to light, dark, shady and glassy. So shady is the AMOLED black pen which is I'm currently using, and glassy is like a little transparent option. And then you have the theme color. You can choose from a lots of theme color, and then you have the accent color, and here you have the material palette and user requested accent colors, so you can choose your favorite accent color here. Sadly we don't have any color for the accent color, but there are so many accent colors that I'm sure you'll find your favorite accent color here. Then the next option is my favorite one, the font manager. As you can see, Havok OS comes preloaded with lots and lots of fonts, and now you don't need to flash any zip or reboot your device to change the font, so that saves a lot of hassle here. And the next option is app icon shape, and you can choose from square, rounded, square, circle, circle, and teardrop and hexagon. Then we have the quick setting themes. Here you can change the quick setting panel opacity. You can also have a custom quick setting header. I'm using a pitch black one, and you can also change the quick setting tile style, and you have a variety of quick setting tile styles here. Here you have a lot of custom quick setting tile styles, and you can choose from any one of them. Each one of them is working perfectly. And below that you have the switch appearance option, where you can change the appearance of these little tick boxes that are coming on the right. You can change from material design to or OnePlus. And then we have the dashboard icon, condition and suggestion option. Now the next option is ambient display. In ambient option, you can choose if you want the ambient display to be always on, or the ambient display should be always on when charging, or if you want the ambient display only for the new notifications. Then you have the other options like double tap to check phone should turn on the ambient display, or lift to check phone should turn on the ambient display. And at last you have the hand wave or pocket gestures. Now if you come back to ambient display settings, you can also turn on the battery level on ambient display and music ticker. So what music ticker does is, it shows you are now playing music info, and when you double tap on it, it changes to the next song. Now coming back to the screen settings, you have smart pixels and screen stabilization. Smart pixels is also one of my favorite features, because what it does is it disables some of the percent of your pixels, and that many percent of pixels are turned off, which means that will save some of your battery. And the next option is screen stabilization. So what screen stabilization does is, it moves your display content when you are in motion or your device is in motion. So the next customization is the rounded corners. If your device doesn't have rounded corners, you can change the rounded corner radius, corner content padding, and the status bar padding. Now coming to buttons, you have a lot of options. First is the hardware keys, where you can disable the hardware keys, swap the hardware keys, enable backlight for buttons and the time. Then you have the power menu customization, where you can choose what all option to show in the power menu. And then we have the screen of torch option. So what it does is, so when I long press the power button when the device is off, it toggles the flashlight, and it's a very handy feature. Then we have the volume rocker settings, like volume panel to be shown on the left side, or volume panel timeout. Then we also have volume steps count, and we can change it from here. Like I've said, the music volume steps to 30. And after that we have the keyboard cursor control. So pressing the volume up button while typing will move the cursor to right side. And then we have the swap keys button, control ring volume, or control music. Now if we come back, then we have individual settings for back button, home button, and overview button, and we can map them to single tap action, long tap action, and double tap action. Then we have the navigation bar. So my device comes with dedicated back and menu key, so I'm not using the navigation bar. But in navigation bar, you can change a lots and lots of things. In navigation bar, you have a setting called smart bar settings, where you can make a smart navigation bar, and you can choose your own custom option to be displayed on the navigation bar. That is a very cool feature, and you should use that if your device doesn't have dedicated navigation buttons. Now then we have the gesture settings, and in gesture settings, you have system gestures. And the first option is jump to camera. So pressing the power button twice will jump to camera, and long press the power button will activate the torch. Then you also have the famous three finger screenshot. Then you have different gesture styles, like gesture anywhere. Gesture anywhere will help you set custom gestures to launch your preferred activity. And then you have the OnePlus gestures, which is swipe up from the left side to go back, and swipe up from the middle to go to the home button. You also have edge gestures, which I'm currently using. Edge gestures is swiping left from the right side of the screen to go back, and swiping in the middle to go home. And then you also have the pie controls. Now the next option is lock screen, and the first setting here is double tap to sleep on lock screen. And then you have the media cover art, and here you can choose if you want to show the media cover art on your lock screen or not. And you can also change the media cover art filter, like blur, grayscale, and accent tinted. And below that you have a music visualizer option. So what it will do is, it will show a music visualizer on your lock screen when some music is playing. Very cool feature. Then you have the widgets, like clock widget and info widget, and you can change the clock style, clock font size, and clock font style also. You can also show weather on your lock screen. And then you have the other settings, like pocket detection, allow fingerprint in pocket mode, and face unlock. And you also have dismiss lock screen automatically when face unlock is recognized. Then you have other options, like whether or not to show these elements on the lock screen, like quick settings, status bar, status check, charging info, and stuff. And at the bottom you have mid-screen shortcuts and bottom shortcuts. So bottom shortcuts are those shortcuts which are displayed on the bottom left and bottom right of your lock screen. And this app also allows you to set up 6 custom mid-screen lock screen shortcuts. And now coming back, you have recent settings. In recent settings, you have different styles, like quick set, grip, Android Go, and slim. You have different customization settings for stop recents and slim recents. You can change the position of clear all button, or you can show a memory bar in the recent panel. You can also blacklist an app so it doesn't shows in the recent menu. Now coming to Havok settings, we have the notification settings. Now the first option is lights, where you can customize the charging LED. And in charging LED, you can change the color of charging LED, like what it should show in low battery, medium battery, or full battery, and what it show when the phone is dash charging. And then you have the notification LED option, where you can configure notification light on per app basis. And then you have the blink flashlight on call, and this is also one of my favorite features. So what it does is, when someone gives you a call, it will start blinking your flashlight, and then you have the heads up status bar notification where you can change its timeout or snooze time, and you can also have notification trigger preview, and below that we have miscellaneous settings like post icon or force expanded notification, and in the bottom you have in call vibration for vibrate on connect, on call waiting, disconnect and notifications. Then we have the animation settings, and here you can change all the system animations and their timeout. Like you can also set up animation for quick styles and power menu or toast, so you can play around with all the settings here. Then we have some system settings like signature spoofing, show CPU info, and there's another feature that I like is privacy guard. So what privacy guard does is it helps you control the permissions given to an app. And now coming back, then we have the battery saving settings. So in battery savings we have sensor block per package. So what it does is it blocks access to certain sensors for some app to save battery. And then we have the alarm blockers and wake lock blockers. So if some alarm or wake lock is eating your battery, you can toggle from here. Then you have advanced dose settings like aggressive battery, and in aggressive battery you can change some settings so that your device goes in the idle mode very fast, and it will help you save some battery. Below that we have suspend action option, where you have some actions which can be done when your device is off, like switch mobile data to 2G or disable mobile data or disable GPS. And at last you have dose settings, so you can change your dose settings here to save more battery life. And now if you come back, then we have some miscellaneous settings, and we also have a dedicated gaming mode. And in gaming mode we can block notification lock buttons, disable gestures, disable automatic brightness, all those options in gaming mode. And then we have the USB configuration options and wake device on charging animation and other stuff. Now these are the havoc settings, but that's not all what the SOM gives you. Let me show you some more options. Like in battery you have smart charging, where you can restrict the charging of your phone up to a certain level. And at the bottom you have devices extra settings, where you can use your alert slider for different settings like notification, flashlight brightness. You can also change your kernel power profile to battery. Now on balance profile, this ROM gives me 4 to 5 hours of screen time. And mind you, I'm a power user, like I have 4 Gmail accounts logged in my device and 2 WhatsApp accounts also. So on balance profile it gives me 4 to 5 hours of screen time, and on battery profile I get around 6 to 7 hours of screen time. And below that you have the OnePlus gestures, like draw 0 to camera or draw B for flashlight. Now these were all the options that this ROM provides you. My final verdict about this ROM is it's a very amazing ROM. Specifically, it is very stable, all the features are working perfectly, and performance has been smooth, no lags, not even in games like PUBG, and the battery life has been great. Also, this ROM has OnePlus camera perfectly working, so give this ROM a try if you love customizing your Android phone. That's all for this video. Hopefully you liked the video. Smash the like button if you did. Comment down which is your favorite ROM. I'll also try to flash HavocOS 3.3, which is Android Q based ROM, in a few days. Subscribe to the channel so you don't miss that video. Thank you for watching.